So now that I've done some analysis on my data, I may wish to preserve that for later. And one way I can do that is by making use of the cart. The cart is a great little tool. It allows me to take an object from one of my displays or for someone else's display and save it for reuse for later. The way that you do that is you take the object that you're interested in. So let's take this trend that I've locked the time range in and I've set up the data points for. We're going to drag this guy into the cart. All right, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this from symbol 1 to boiler 210. Double click, boiler 210 trend. And what you'll notice is when I expand this object, I get not only the data streams, but I also get the information about the time range. And what's interesting is that these items are individually available to apply to other things. So if I wanted to apply the water to this other trend for boiler 210, I could certainly trend him there. I could also make him into a new object on my screen. So if I want to make him a value, for example, here's an instant value on water, which is kind of cool. I can also apply either the start time, the end time, or both to another object on the screen. So if I take the time range, apply them to this trend on the bottom, it actually applied it to the entire display. So if I had a table or other trends on my screen, everything would have assumed this time range. Remember, this plot is locked, so that didn't change. But the cart allows me to reuse part or the whole of an object that I've saved. And again, I can pull in objects to my cart from other displays that other people have built, which makes it very useful and very collaborative.